In this video, I'm going to talk about graphing using intercepts. Out of all the ways to graph, this is actually my least favorite method of graphing, but a lot of students actually prefer this method of graphing because it's a little bit more visual and there's a little bit of arithmetic involved in this, and some students like to do all that arithmetic. I don't necessarily need to. I think there's a better way to do this. But anyway, this is one way of doing this. This also helps us to understand what an x-intercept and what a y-intercept is. So that actually is a good part of what we're doing here. Okay, so anyway, we're going to graph using intercepts. So that's actually, we're going to figure out this equation here. We're going to figure out where it hits the y-axis, and then we're also going to figure out where it hits the x-axis on a grid. And so with those two points, if we graph those two points, then we'll be able to graph wherever the line is supposed to be. Okay, so normally some equations are written this way. Notice that the x and the y are on the left side of the equal sign. Okay, notice that both of them are on the left. That is traditionally what we call the standard form of an equation, where we have all the variables on the left side and then the numbers on the right. So you see the x variable and then the y variable on the left and then the number on the right. That's traditionally how we see it. Okay, so if you have an equation in this form, we can find the intercepts. Now, to find the intercepts, there's two things you got to do. We got to find the x-intercept and we got to find the y-intercept. So I'm going to show finding the x-intercept first. Okay, so x-int, that's x-intercept. I'm going to do that first. Now, to do this, to find the x-intercept, and this is kind of counterintuitive, what we're going to do is we're going to assume that y is equal to 0. Okay, so again, a little counterintuitive. To find the x-intercept, we want to see when the y is 0. We want to assume the y-coordinate is 0. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to take this equation and we're going to plug in that y is equal to 0 into this equation. So it's going to look like this. 4x minus 2 times 0 equals 8. Okay, so now we're just plugging in, and now what we're going to do is since we only have one variable left, we just have this x variable left, we're going to solve for that x variable. Okay, now I know some of you are thinking, oh, solving, I got to do algebra, I got to do all this extra work. It's not really actually that complicated. You should love working with zero because notice what happens right here, negative 2 times 0, that is 0. That simply just goes away. All I'm left with is 4x is equal to 8. Then all I need to do is divide by 4 on both sides, and then x is equal to 2. So actually, it doesn't take very much to find out what the x-intercept is going to be. Okay, now what am I supposed to do with this? The intercepts are supposed to be coordinates. I'm supposed to have an x coordinate, then a y coordinate. This is only one number, so what's this mean? Okay, there's two ways to look at this. The first way, which I actually don't use, but some students do, since this is an x-intercept, they just go with the vocabulary. X-intercept, that's where it hits the x-axis. So I'm going to take this number, this is where it hits the x-axis, and bring that number to the x-axis. That number was 2, so it's right here. Okay, that's one way to look at it. That's one way to see where the x-intercept is at. The other way to see it, and this is what I do, okay, I know that the y is 0, that's one thing I assumed, y is 0, and then the x is 2. That actually gives you a coordinate of 2, 0. And with the coordinate x2, y0, I come back to my origin, an x of 2 and a y of 0. Okay, it's the exact same point. So again, two different ways to see where that point is supposed to be. I just want to show you both ways because, again, students prefer one thing or the other. All right, so that is how to find the x-intercept. Now let's look at finding the y-intercept. So y-intercept, again, INT stands for intercept. So as you can well imagine, and I'm going to go a little bit faster through this, is that for the x-intercept, I assume that y was equal to 0. Okay, you can kind of assume that we're going to do the same over here. For the y-intercept, I'm going to assume that the x is equal to 0. Okay, so we kind of switch it up depending on which one we're trying to find. So now we're going to use the same equation again. So 4 times 0, okay, make sure you put the x equals 0, make sure you put it in the right spot, minus 2y equals 8. Okay, we don't want to do this equation all over again. And again, love working with 0 because everything goes away. So 4 times 0 is 0, so that goes away. So I'm left with 2y on that left side, and then all I need to do is divide by negative 2, and that gives me a negative 4. So divide by negative 2 here, they'll cancel, and then 8 divided by negative 2 is negative 4. So again, here, two ways of thinking. y equals negative 4. This is a y-intercept, so I can go to the y-axis and look for negative 4, which is all the way down here. Okay, that's one way to think of it. Or my preferred way is that I look, okay, here's a y of negative 4. There's an x of 0, so 0, negative 4 is my point. So an x of 0, okay, don't go left or right, and then a y of negative 4, which is this point right down here. So again, the same point. Two different ways to look at it, but it's the same point. All right, so that is my, that's how I find the x-intercept and the y-intercept. And now that I have those two points, now what I can do is I can draw a line between them. So I'm going to use green to do the line between them. So I'll start somewhere down here. And there we go. Okay, it didn't quite perfectly go through there, but I have my two points that are easily visible. And there's my line. And that's it. That is graphing using intercepts. It's pretty simple, but you got to make sure that you understand the steps. The most difficult thing, I think, about this is that when you have an x-intercept, you make the y equal to 0, and then you solve to get a point. And then it's opposite when you want a y-intercept, set the x equal to 0, plug it in, solve it, and you get your other coordinate. There's a little bit of algebra involved with this method, so that's why sometimes it's not popular with students, but it's still a good method to use because you can see where the x-intercept is. You can see where the y-intercept is. And depending on whether this is a word problem or not, that x and y-intercept usually tells you something about the story. Sometimes it'll tell you where you started at. Sometimes it'll tell you where you end at. Again, depends on the word problem. But anyway, make sure that when you're using intercepts, when you have an equation that looks like this, these are the two things you look for. Find the x-intercept, find the y-intercept, and this is the way to do that. All right, then that is graphing lines using intercepts. Thank you for watching the video.